America's newest nuclear stealth bomber made its debut on December 2nd after years of secret development. It's the first new stealth bomber in 30 years. The rollout at Northrop Grumman's facility at the Air Force's Plant 42 in Palmdale, California, was the first time the public got a glimpse of this futuristic warplane. Northrop Grumman called it the world's first sixth-generation aircraft, which means it's a lot more technologically advanced than any other military jet. The first flight is expected sometime this year. While almost every aspect of the program is classified, a fair idea about its weapons package can be made. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what weapons will B-21 Raider carry. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. The Stormbreaker measures 69 inches long, 6 inches in diameter, 68 inches in wingspan, and weighs 204 pounds, or 93 kilograms. Its small size enables them to be carried in greater numbers. Stormbreaker has a maneuverable airframe and deployable wings which provide an improved standoff range. The weapon has a range of 45 miles, or 72 kilometers, against moving targets, and 69 miles, or 110 kilometers, for stationary targets. The Stormbreaker can use a GPS or INS system for initial guidance to move into the general vicinity of a moving target, and then use updates from the UHF data link to home in on the target during the final descent. Importantly, the Seeker and Stormbreaker has 3 modes for diverse operational scenarios: millimeter wave radar to detect and track targets through adverse weather conditions and battlefield dust and debris, infrared imaging for enhanced target detection through the heat signature of the target, and a semi-active laser that enables it to track an airborne or ground target that's illuminated with a laser designator. Half of the total weapon's weight is the warhead alone. The shaped charge plasma jet technology multifunctional warhead is effective not only against unhardened structures and infantry vehicles, but also against heavily armored main battle tanks. The AGM-158 Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile is a stealthy and highly precise subsonic surface-skimming cruise missile with a range of 230 miles, or 370 kilometers. It's developed and produced by Lockheed Martin. It can carry warheads weighing up to 450 kilograms, or 990 pounds. The JASSM flies automatically through a predetermined route by using the onboard inertial navigation system that includes anti-jam global positioning system, AJGPS, and a ring layer gyro inertial measurement unit. Additional navigation and guidance features on the air-to-surface missile include an imaging infrared I2R seeker and automatic target correlator ATC for a high-precision strike rate. It can also carry powered, low-cost, autonomous attack system LOCAS, submunitions integrating a dual-mode laser detection and ranging LADAR system, and a millimeter wave MMW seeker. AGM-158B JASSM-ER is the extended-range variant of AJM-158 JASSM. It has a range of 925-plus kilometers, or 575-plus miles. While a Teledyne J402-100 turbojet engine powers the JASSM, the JASSM-ER is equipped with a Williams International turbofan engine. AGM-158C LRASM is essentially an anti-ship variant of AGM-158 JASSM, which is the Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile. The stealth missile is designed to strike ships as far away as 300 miles, or 480 kilometers, though the exact range could be more. The missile is subsonic, but since it's LO, low observable, the enemy warship won't see it coming till it's very close. It's powered by an F-107 turbofan engine and has a 1,000-pound or 450-kilogram blast fragmentation penetrator. The warhead is potent enough to cripple a large warship. It uses an inertial and jam-resistant GPS navigation system for the initial phase of the journey, a two-way data link for mid-course, and a radio frequency and infrared sensor for the terminal phase. In the terminal phase, the missile skims close to the surface, which makes it hard to intercept. It's important to note that LRASMs can be deployed in swarm mode, which will enable them to saturate enemy defenses. The B-61 Mod 12 is the latest iteration of the B-61 series nuclear bomb. The bomb has a kit that's equipped with tail fins to control the bomb's downward descent and will enable it to dive down on the target with high accuracy. The B-61 Mod 12 also uses rockets in the main body to spin-stabilize it in flight and improve its accuracy. The bomb's exact power remains classified. Some reports indicate that the warhead will have a maximum yield of approximately 50 kilotons. To give viewers a perspective, here's a comparison. Trinity test in New Mexico in July 1945, which ushered in the nuclear age, had a yield of 20 kilotons. Hiroshima's Little Boy bomb had a yield of 13 to 18 kilotons, whereas Nagasaki's Fat Man bomb had a yield of 20 to 22 kilotons of TNT. B-61-12 is expected to have a dial-a-yield capability, which can limit the extent of the nuclear reaction inside the warhead to lower the explosive force. This way, a B-61 Mod 12 will be able to replace different bombs that have predefined explosive yields. The B-61 Mod 12 will also replace the B-61-11 Bunker Buster variant. While all the weapons listed till now are operational, this one's not online yet. AGM-181 Long Range Standoff Weapon, LRSO, is a nuclear-armed, air-launched cruise missile under development by Raytheon Technologies that will replace the AGM-86 ALCM. The range is expected to be similar or a bit more than the AGM-86 and will be about 2,500 kilometers or about 1,550 miles. There is no concept image released by Raytheon, but the missile is expected to have stealth characteristics so as to make it low observable. This will make the missile hard to detect, track, and intercept. The idea is that the stealth features will enable the missile to penetrate integrated air defenses fielded by adversaries like China and Russia. The missile is also likely to feature anti-jamming capabilities so that it can't be deceived by the enemy's electronic countermeasures, or ECM, attacks. As per reports, LRSO will not be a hypersonic weapon, and the weapon will not have a conventional variant.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.